Ibanez musician. Kind of nice looking. I think it's got those active battery type electronics. Just needs a little bit of setup. I mean, that's working way too hard. Let's see if the neck is straight enough to give us love. Right, here we are again. Over and over and over again. Anything worth doing is worth doing over and over and over again. Forget about doing it right. Just do it over and over again. Right now, yeah, the neck's pretty bent. So let's just see what happens. You guys know the drill. And you girls, too. Well, it's in there, and we can tell by the missing paint, it's not a virgin hole. Looks like a 5 mil. Let's see what happens. So, as always, yeah, so I need the one that's 5 mil, but it's a shorty. I think. What has happened down here? Oh, even shorter than that? It's so buried in there. Let's try the D-handle. Right. Come out. There you are. Let's see what we can get here. Well, I can sort of grab it with that. I did have a shorty, shorter one than that. I thought that was a really short. That's not a 5 mil. I really don't like using the T-handle. And just the way that's buried in there, it looks like that's the weapon of choice. So, yeah, it's one of those. Turning. Okay, let's loosen the strings a bit and see what we can do. Well, I'm going to use a little mechanical assist. You can get a friend to help. Today I've got a clamp and the thing's clamped to the bench. And I did manage to get the right hex key in there. Am I getting a turn out of this? Possibly, but it's pretty stiff. But it's stiff, folks. Really don't give you a lot of room to get in there and grab this. Well, I got about a half a turn out of it. Let's tune it back up. I did not plug it in to see if it makes sound. And see what happens. I don't know. That's a good sign. Fight this one a bit. Back to my speech about incremental truss rod adjustments over time. Letting guitars sit, and basses for that matter, and not keeping an eyeball on the neck straightness. How often do I see this? Hey folks, like a lot? And then, you know, everyone gets all blinded by the bling. Oh, look at it. Isn't that what a great looking bass guitar? It looks amazing. Look at it. But the truss rod doesn't work. Now I got something out of it. Now we're good. Say a prayer to the God of Truss Rod. Ah, the old string height. Which is definitely set like ass. We've got, who does this? 864s. And then we taper down to 5 on the one side. Like, they're all different. You can have the string action high. You can have the string action low. You can have the string action in the middle. But the string action needs to match the curve of the fingerboard. So you can't have like one string up like this, and one down, and then another one up, and then how can you play that? Okay, so 664s would be considered high string action. I prefer to set it in the middle at 564s. If you start cheating it down to 464s, depending on your playing style, you might get some rattle. You might get some fret buzz. Alright. I like that. That's gonna come way down too. I like that one. That needs to come up a hair. So they had the heavy string set really high, and then they had the smaller string set somewhere sort of in between. So they were all different. Now we're good. Let's retune it. Get some pickup height and some intonation. So it appears that this one, the bridge pickup, is, it's okay. That's way too far away. Will it move, or is it what it is? Sometimes it is what it is. Why can't it just be what it isn't sometimes? I don't think this moves. I think it's planted. Yeah, it's planted. That's all it does. That's all he gave us. It sits in the hole, and that's where it goes. So, say. Of the neck, and I like it. String action's good, intonation's good. Put the little cover on and call it quits. While I'm doing that, just want to thank everybody who recently grabbed stickers. But I will remind you, please double check that I get your address. I'll do the PayPal tutorial one more time. If you get a sticker and you click the thing that it's a purchase, PayPal automatically sends me your address and automatically takes a chunk of money for that privilege. If you just send the money, right?
PayPal does not include your address. Mainly because if you're not buying anything and you send money, why would I need your address? So I always send out an email, folks, right away to the email address that is provided by PayPal if I do not have your address. If you do not get your sticker within a week, please double check that I got your address. Check your email, check your spam, check your PayPal. Reach out to me. Thanks for hanging out, folks. Shout out to my patrons. Facebook group, book face plant people, Twitter people, my subscribers, everybody, all the ships at sea. Be good to each other. Cheers.